Here, I'm going to show you how to make a password prompt in Excel. And here's our window. We go to input the password, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or whatever it is, and you see the asterisks. So I'm going to show you how to do that, and it's still going to ingest the correct password so that you can use it wherever you want. In this case, when we click submit, we're going to output it in a message box so that we can verify that everything is working correctly. And then when we hit OK, everything will close and we can do whatever we want. And this feature works really, really well with a bunch of other little things that I've shown you how to do, including password protecting and hiding worksheets. And I'll put a link to that in the description of this video. And I'm going to show you how to make this even if you don't know a single thing about code or user forms. Now make sure to subscribe, hit the like button and the bell icon so that you can get all of my new tutorials. And if you want to download this file, click the link below the video. All right, let's go ahead and build this guy. And we want to go to the VBA window for that. So hit Alt F11 on the keyboard and then go to Insert and go to User Form. And we should have a little toolbox like this and a blank user form over here. If you don't see the toolbox, you can click the little toolbox icon right here or go to a View and Toolbox right here. And what we want to do is to add a button and a simple input. So we click Command Button, then go to where we want to place it and either click once or click and drag to change the size of it. Or you can change the size afterwards by clicking one of the corners. And we will move it just a little bit. And let's go ahead and do a text box for the input. So click that guy, and we'll just click it once to get the default size. And then maybe make it a little bit bigger here. And let's click this and drag it up here. And maybe make this a little smaller. And if you want to give it a title, go ahead and click the A right here, and that's going to get you a label, and you can play around with that. But let's focus on the password input. I'm going to rename this guy, so click it, and go over here in the Properties window. If you don't see that, go to a View and Properties window, or F4. So we go up to the Name box, and let's change this to TXT Password. Hit Enter. And let's go down here to Command Button 1 and let's double click the name CMD and let's just change it to Input. And let's go to the caption and we will select it, delete it, and type Submit. And in the Properties window, we can play around with the formatting and the size, and we have many, many things that we can do. But what's important for this one is go back to the text box and then we want to go all the way down to where it says Password Char. Click in that and type the character that you want to appear when you type your password. So I want the little asterisk, so I'm going to hit Shift 8 on my keyboard and I get the asterisk right there. Now we can click the form and hit the play button to run it. And when I click in here and start typing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you see the little asterisk. So we have our nice little password input. And to close the window, we can hit the red X. But now let's go ahead and make this guy work. And actually, I'm going to change the title of the form really quickly. So, user form, let's change the caption to password prompt. And the name for user form, change it to FRM password. And now let's double-click the submit button. We're now in the code window behind the form. And let's go ahead and get the value from the text box. So type the name of it, TXT, and control space to autofill that in. And if you have multiple text boxes, when you do that, you're going to get a little drop-down menu here, and you can select the correct one. So TXT password dot value. And now what do we want to do with it? Whatever you want to do with it. Here, I'm just going to output it in a message box so that you can see the result of it. And then let's go ahead and close the form. Unload me. Simple, nice, neat, and easy. And if you try to close the form from outside the form, you can go ahead and type the name of the form, FRM password. Control space to autofill that in once again. But we are inside the form now, so we're going to leave it at me. And let's click play and see what happens. Here we are. We type our password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and hit submit. And there we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can see that it is ingested exactly the way that the user types it, and you can now check it against your list to see if it's the correct password or not. And then once I hit OK, it runs the code to close the form. And that is all there is to creating a password prompt with a nice little character so that you cannot see what's being typed in. The text box, properties window, and go to password char, and then type in the character that you want to be there. I will quickly show you what happens if you type another character, let's say a plus, and we go and run it. Now we will get plus signs. But the very last thing you may want to do is to run this guy from somewhere other than this window. So let's go ahead and insert a module and make a sub called run form, or whatever you want to call it. And let's run our user form. Type the name of the form, FRM, control space to fill it in. If it couldn't figure out what you were typing, it'd give you a whole list of options. And what do we want to do? We want to show that. So now we can go back to the worksheet, hit Alt F8, and we have a macro. We can assign it to a button if we want, and run it, and there we go.